哎，你们有没有什么问题啊？中国人啊，要问什么问题就赶快，有吗？有哈？没？有？OK，说。
师傅，那因为听老同学说那个说师傅早期有说过释迦牟尼佛说。如果要了脱三界，一定要断了夫妻关系。
啊，谁讲？
一位老同学讲。
老同学讲，OK。然后呢？
那是突然矛盾，是不是要继续保持单身？
那个，你还是单身吗？
是。
那就别问嘛。不关你的事了。奇怪，啊？你意思说要不有没有一个男朋友瞪着你啊？有了哈，你要不要瞪着他？
如果一定要保持单身才可以了脱三界，那我当然选择单身。
三界已经了了，现在看你要不要了别的界了。这个界要不要了就看你了。这个三界是我管了。OK， 好。如果你没有他会死的话，那不要没有他了，我要管那个了脱生死，怕了不到那个心呢、啊。不过我告诉你啊，有时候啊，认为好玩了，有没有认识他了？我是瞪来瞪去而已，
瞪来瞪去，
瞪来瞪去而已，啊，碰碰看嘛。然后再跟我说情况如何，那个时候我们再说。I don't know, OK? 你问那个单身的女孩子，我好几忘记了。我不想再想这个东西，别问了 ，OK? 你就问那些老同学嘛，那些
太老了也忘了。
开玩笑你。看到年轻轻还忘了，OK， 碰碰看吧。我告诉你，有时候看你好玩啊，认为幻想嘛，认为会怎么样怎么样，结果现在登来登去看几眼而已哈。那等一下碰碰看，也许有别的事情哈。哦，等一下过来久以后也是登来登去而已了。过了一阵子也是瞪来瞪去，跟现在一样。
现在都不瞪了，
连瞪也不瞪了。
我告诉你，
你说谎。你刚来的时候，我看你们两个都木住。
我再说试一试。
瞪个那个，瞪个那个那么大，他们两个坐的都面的坐。我有注意看的。有讲过了，有介绍过了 ，OK。不过也许他们坐一坐的斗面而已，瞪不瞪的了，告诉我。那你自己选择嘛。我真的没有办法 ，OK。我忘记了，你再问我，我又在想那些事情才能回答你。我都不如不要再想了啦。我跟狗了要懒得跟人，我告诉你。他们简单处理，你叫他坐哪里，他坐哪里。你给他一点东西，他吃，他就高兴了。啊，每一次你回来，都跟新的认识一样。Hello, master. 你看，你有没有一个先生，你回来他这样做？有没有那么欢迎你？哪有？饭菜呀、啊，有没有？今天煮什么？怎么这个时候还没饭？整天做了还什么东西？啊，告诉你啊，又有一个头发在那个 soup 里面。你喜欢不喜欢他？
印象还不错。
啊？
印象不错。
你喜欢不喜欢他？
哦，有一点。
一点了多少点？一点而已啊。何必麻烦嘛？告诉你啊，任何男孩子或是女孩子，如果你没有他， 你不能活下去，那个时候我们再谈 ，OK？ 现在一点，这可不算 ，OK？ 明天找到一个男孩子来喜欢他两点就麻烦了。什么时候我喜欢他20%就 OK 了，啊，那个时候我救不了了，算了算了 ，OK， 你爱怎么就什么。现在一点而已，我们就不管了 ，OK， 我不跟你谈那个一点的事情，好吗？还有什么事？
啊，你今天讲您的这个故事，我不知道应该怎么办，这头脑是不是应该发一次，还是应该不管他？
啊 ，OK， 那看情况嘛。如果你登来登去的话，那个那个是不一样啊。如果要想吃一个假 party 而已，那把它吃下去就算了。在那边争争吵吵好几年，干嘛啊？你要什么假 party？ 我是男孩子。啊？我
不是已经有一个男孩子了。
哪一个？这个？那你还要什么东西？要不更重要吗？还有什么更？
我就是特别想回家，然后
哪里家？
就是解脱，对，特别想解脱。
哦，那个慢慢来，没关系，
慢慢
过了几年就会了。
我就是想知道我能不能回去，然后
现在啊，你丢他在这边给我养啊？看你很善良啊，那丢他干嘛？等一下大家一起去了。嗯，我告诉你啊，目前啊，人家都怕那个世界末日哈，赶快去做那个 SMTV 啊 Flyer 什么的，然后也许一起也可以去了，要不用赶快了 ，OK？ 几年而已，如果没有做，没有人真的严肃做什么事的话，你不用要求了，他自己会来。那个解脱他会找你。现在要救人了 ，OK？ 不想自己那么多，好不好？
好。
我们能剩下多少时间就救人吧，好不好？啊，然后如果能救的整个世界就好，如果不能的话，我们救几个好几个。然后那个时候一起去 ，OK？ 不丢他在这边，我没空养这个这种人。OK，next、okay, one。
师傅，我没有什么问题要问。几个月以前我回一趟大陆，看望我的父母，然后看到我城市里面的师兄师姐们，他们非常想念师傅，也非常爱师傅。
你要怎么样？
他们因为不能看到师傅，所以让我带来他们的祝福。
嗯。
祝师父永远健康快乐，永远美丽。谢谢。
我也很想念他们啊，又怎么样呢？怎么做 ？OK， Thank you 啊，
谢谢师父。
跟他们说一样 ，OK， 总部一模一样，
谢谢
好不好？我没办法 ，Yeah，Thank you。每一次碰到大陆都讲一样的事情，他非常想念师父，非常爱师父，他不知道怎么办，我也是没办法。笑一点好不好？跟他们说，每一次都讲一样，哦，难过死了。我们即使要快死的话，死的快乐的一点好不好？OK，next、okay, one， 你耶，
师傅你好，
你头发现在怎么那么短？
刚刚剪，上两个月剪而已、啊。
何必剪呢？
他有时候太长，打禅不方便嘛。没有洗澡。
打禅跟那个头发有什么关系啊？
我这几天也想再剪短的，几天没办法洗头发。
不习惯洗了。我知道了，因为那边没水了。没有 bathroom 是不是？
对对。
OK、
啊。我香港中心啊，就很谢谢师傅了。最近这一年呢。就给我们很多机会颁奖啊，去很多地方，包括一些大陆啊，还有一些偏远地方的。
Yeah.
然后在颁奖的过程里面呢，就我们也接触很多人，也学到很多东西。
嗯。
而且比如说最近在印度，去印度那个颁奖给那个女孩子，救了五个人
那个
五个人那个，那中间呢就 因为那个女孩子很难找得到，她在很乡下的地方。
是啊，你们怎么找到？真的厉害。
哦，我们也拜托很多人帮忙，有政府的官员啊，有一些领事馆啊，
哇，
就找到领事馆那边，还有一些印度的报馆呢、啊，报纸那边记者啊，
yeah.
很多人一起学校啊帮忙一起找。
Yeah.
所以从中间里面呢，经常跟很多人就会谈到师父的教理啊，
嗯，
他们很多也很喜欢，
嗯，
而且也送一些。最近师父的书啊给他们呢、嗯、啊、
yeah.
小了的书啊那些给他们、yeah. 所以从中间里面我们同修就去了一个大概十天在印度、
哦、
这中间又碰到印度的一个德里的一个联络人他也很努力他因为印度同修不是很集中小中心德里现在还没有他一个人呢因为他知道我们现在师父也在努力去发展那个 SMTV 啊，那个活动，
yeah.
所以他现在自己盖了，在盖，正在盖一个小中心，
嗯，
哈、啊，就也是一边盖小中心，一边希望发展、
嗯
啊、那个他在印度的那个弘法的事情。
呀、yeah, ，然后，
因为我们也需要很多样书，去、
嗯、
去印度那边一边发给
顺便发、yeah.
对，一边发给人啊，一边做事情嘛。然后样书组就刚好跟我们说啊。新翻译的印度文的样书就刚出来了
Sorry,
就刚刚翻译好就可以马上印、
yeah.
马上印了两种印度文的一种是 Hindi 一种是、yeah. Assumption 是吧
Assumption
OK 然后就在很短的时间里面就马上做了马上印好大概一万本、
嗯、
就发过去
就
他看到我们的时候很高兴，因为他一个人在盖房子就忙不过来，
oh.
然后他以为我们是帮忙他来盖房子，因为可能他
好失望啊，
他里面有求师傅帮忙嘛。
你们有没有帮忙啊？
我们说我们有重要的事情，有另外重要的事情做，所以
OK
也有帮忙他发样书了
，Yeah OK，
样书发不完就留给他
，Yeah OK
这样子。
啊 ，poor guy。
所以，是很谢谢师父给香港一些机会去，去那个地方。
没什么，问题很小。
啊，我是报告到这里。
Very good， 谢谢thank you 。没问题 ，OK，Thank you。
我们那个十几年来啊，华务部聘我们做啊这个监狱的辅导团体。
嗯。
那么三年前呢，他就有一个是。免起诉缓起诉的一个聘书缓起诉就是说他的刑期他犯罪很轻、
嗯、
而且判他罚钱啦、啊、辅导役啦、
啊、去
劳动服务然后再教育那我们是东部地区三四个地区的唯一的再教育团体缓、
嗯、
起诉就是说他犯刑
犯轻轻的人比较不大众的那种
还不大众他就是不要他关了、
啊、给你们
不用关
啊，给你们不用关你管的那些是多少个小时
他来听我们的师傅的录影带啦、
oh, okay.
几个小时那么他就不用关、
oh.
那不用关的话他就可以保存他的工作家庭不用破碎、
oh, 对对对、
哎、他个人在社会生存非常重要、
oh,
那我们是华务部委托我们做这样的事情、
oh, wow, 哎、保护他的名誉呢、哎、
是是不用他关
懂懂、
哎、他判三个
okay,
然后我们这两年来我们把师父的打坐啦、
嗯
啊、然后师父的、救援的状况、
嗯、
然后每一个月给他们杂志、
嗯、
然后每一次研究一篇文章、
嗯、
他们最喜欢看师父在世界讲经、
嗯
还有就是救援的状况很感动、嗯、我们从事十几年啊就对于灵性的部分他比较能够感动
嗯
尤其看到师父他在世界各地救援左紧的部分到一个偏远地方左紧啊、
嗯、
哦原来这么苦的人都没有水喝
嗯对
他们无法想象这一点、啊、还有看到师父在西湖讲经他们有一个受刑人非常感动
嗯
他说如果我能够看这些东西我可能不会为了小事然后去喝酒、
嗯、
然后去犯错
懂懂
那为什么这么这么慢去接触这个灵性的东西、
嗯哎、没有人叫他
我们每一次给他阅读、
嗯、
一篇文章然后写下来、
嗯、
然后有一个他们比较惊讶的是 有一个自闭症，从来不讲话的，不知道发生什么，现在不讲话的。然后我们一年多，我们辅导两年嘛，一年多的时间，他就讲话了。然后我们辅导的时候有四五个人，全部都让他独立，有工作做。他们就很顺利，每一个人都可以工作，自己养自己。然后自闭症那个人可以说话，还可以说话，那个终于说话，然后自己有工作做。
有进步。
对，那我们这一些。这些东西华部要求我们写下来它的转变记录下来，然后请全省的地检处人去听我们这个报告，然后这个报告大概写了四五个千字，然后他们写的师傅的感言，每一篇文章的感言有写下来，然后很欣慰的就是没有再犯例，然后每一个人都有工作，然后可以谈。
OK，
谢谢师傅，感恩。
不客气。OK， 你们能做什么就做什么啊，这样子很好啊，对社会有帮助，我就高兴了，何必谢谢呢？
刚刚这个师姐讲这个事情，其实我想起来就是密苏里州啊，在这方面是在全美的模型，就是他们的年轻犯罪只要不要杀人犯，就是他们就把他们组织一个小组，四五个人放在一个 family， 来 educate them， 就教育他们，引导他们，采用正面的办法。所以那个我们已经在联系跟他们 interview。这个师姐，如果你能可不可以把你们有些资料给我们送一份过来，我们也可以跟他们交流交流，也许他们可以学得更多。
也许这样。OK， 跟他合作，可以跟他。沟通一下好吗？
Okay.
这些法律的那种语言呢、我听不大懂，不过我懂你们都有教育他们了、然后他们转变了生活进步，这样我高兴了。 OK， 别的细节的话拜托再写一遍清楚一点是什么啊。哎，下一个 next one yeah
师父，如果我们呢发一些信给一些政府和一些官员呢，就劝导他们吃素，就刚才因为师父讲到那个现在那个世界的情况很严重嘛，开始就如果我们发一些信，就劝导他们吃素啊，注意环保啊，和一些我们的对世界好的办法了，就
可以啊，
奉献给他们，
可以试看看啊。OK， 因为这个我们不是说政治什么嘛。OK， OK，
懂。
我们就拜托他们呢、做善事啊，不要吃动物的肉，因为有因果嘛。因为有因果太多的话，有时候都会太多因果哈，太多那个业煞业哈，也会很难控制，很难救啊。OK，
因为我们在颁奖给陈飞的时候呢，那个环保农民那个，他也是从他们那个政府那边开始就劝导他们环保。竹篮子那个，不要人家用塑胶袋。
对 ，OK。呼，大陆哈，哇、wow, ，I don't know， 你们去看看吧啊，因为如果从台湾写的话，从香港写，你们去香港哈。
香港，我是写给香港而已。
香港政府啊，去看看吧。因为香港已经知道你们存在嘛，谁能够写给谁，政府就写嘛 ，OK。总统那边宣布说自由那个信仰嘛，希望如是。不过我也不晓得自由信仰就是那些已经发展的信仰，或是所有都可以的那种，懂不懂？我是也是慢慢来再说吧。OK， 世界很困难，有时候我觉得我碰到墙壁一样啊。我们就做那个叫什么 SMTV 啊，是最广的，懂不懂？最尽量的，然后私底下又。发那个 flyer 传单啊，还有书啊，书啊什么也很重要呢。读书印经的人为了看书看杂志来的 ，OK？ 看书看杂志就是他认识什么那个同修嘛，同修给他那个书啊借看看这样子，然后那个人就借那本书借好几个这样子，然后他们看书了就很了解了嘛，然后才进来印经啊。那电视就是给。广大群众的，认识不认识无所谓的 ，OK， 多数都不认识的，然后慢慢来，他们转变了，转变很多，不过太慢了，我 过去，我如果我能控制的话，全部叫大家吃素了，然后连这样子哈，自然草木也会长出来了。因为目前就是为了吃肉啊，为了养动物啊，它砍很多树林啊 ，OK， 还有换了很多水啊，好的水啊，然后很多原能呢，为了养动物就对了哈。啊，然后杀他们的话，那业障太多 ，OK， 越杀越多业障，然后所以有时候种树啊，转变那个毒气啊，也不是说最主要的办法的，最主要就是免了杀生的业障，因为杀太多无辜的众生啊，然后累世的业障出来，那个是最重要要免的。连这个的话，连别的他自己也来的，懂不懂？心善良了以后，就想通很多事情啊。没有业障的时候，那个天使啊、天堂会保佑地球更多。现在他们也无法，因为业障多了，英国的那个王啊，他要惩罚人啊，不是上帝要惩罚人，这个法官要惩罚的，不是总统，懂不懂？像在台湾你认识总统，总统爱你没关系，不过你犯法的话就是要法官处理的，他也无法了，他的部下也没办法，他的那个 bodyguard 什么也不能保护你的，了解我意思吗？就是这样子的情况啊，因为众生人民太无名了，给然后一己杀业太多了，懂不懂？所以天使现在天堂也是无能了。有时候我也觉得很挫折了，也不知道还在做什么，还在能做什么，所以全部就是发动在那个 SMTV， 看谁能看，谁能懂，谁能转就转了。因为即使我们哈，整天整完就去发传单，整天整完就去讲经，也不晓得到什么时候再讲完，给全部第九看到，懂不懂？只有那个 SMTV， 只有能够希望他能够多广播出来而已，懂不懂？因为你们也有工作啊，有自己的国家，不能每天跑出去发传单，一个传单能影响多少？不过有影响啊。很多人是为了个传单的，因为他拿到这个以后，他好奇嘛，多研究啊，跟那个世俗的人研究，是跟我们团体的那个网络啊研究，然后就会动心，然后会转很多了。不过我们做到什么时候才能够全部每个人拿到一个，了解吗？还有多少人就会玩过来跟网络联络，是跟素食人联络，懂不懂我意思？所以这个电视他天天看，然后一定有一天会撑到脑袋里面了，了解哈 ？OK， 所以就是这样子，只有那个办法是目前是其中最好的 ，OK， 最意思说最有效的啦，最能够借助哈，会借助到很多人，你看。然后我们试着上还要发传单啊，要借书啊，要借 DVD， 要借电视看看等等哈，广告电视给他们直接看等等。不过我觉得好慢好慢啊，没关系啦，看情况嘛，啊无所谓啦 ，OK， 我们死就死，活是活，无所谓，反正死一次啊，早一次，晚也是啊，OK 啊，事实上哈。我们就说 OK， 我们要保留这个世界给我们的小孩，这样子，这个是物质方面讲的话 OK。 不过如果世界道德不够的话，连我们保留一个完美世界他们也拿不到，他们也没办法保存或是享受啊。有的话有时候又生这个病生那个病啊，瘟疫啊，然后他人家也死啊，美丽世界也是差不多了，听懂不懂？美丽世界应该有美丽道德拥护才永久，才干净，我们人才能够心想。没有道德的话，美丽世界、丑世界也是差不多了。OK， 所以最主要就是世俗，劝人家世俗啊，这个很难。他们被那个洗脑好久了，几千万年了，我们一下子真的不容易做。 我们尽量而已哈，尽量最少我们良心安稳嘛，说知道我们做最好了，我们知道怎么做就尽量做，就是这样子而已啊。OK， 然后人家能转心啊，转改他们的意念啊，他们就转，不转我们也是没有办法了。OK， 能救多少就救多少。OK 哈，这个时间比较急了，嗯。好 ，Next one。
最近在做就是有关狗宝贝、鸟宝贝，后来到那个无上士电视台，然后我们在佛摩萨我们有做笔啊，做文具，
yeah.
然后一直到最后我们做了一个东西，然后西湖叫我们不能送的，就是那个随身带的那个面纸。
面纸？
对啊，因为面纸上面有印了无上士电视台，就师父拿那个 walkie talkie 那个照片的。然后外面是印了
哦，为什么印那个呢？
对啊，是啊，所以我们就说我冲太快了，所以要跟师傅报告一下。
有很多可以印，何必印那个呢？嗯，就给人家，比方说一个小宝宝啊，小的钱袋啊，什么 purse、哦、那些也是小小的。
可以啊，快要过年，我们可以来印。
用很久啊，对，我是可以印红包也可以等等，比方说这样。因为那种人家丢掉了，但是不能用啊，你给他等一下他丢掉了也何必呢，那么浪费，给什么人家可以用比较永久的，
是
就比较不是他看而已，等一下他隔壁也看到，然后他朋友也看到，他的工作人员也看到，他同伴也看到，哎，他到处都带嘛，那我说随便人家比较看到。那个卫生纸他感冒一天就不见了。没有到一天呢、啊。
能不能印那个 notepad？ 那个因为你 notepad 就写这小条的。
嗯，他写，等一下看看就丢掉了。嗯，这种 note 不长久，除了他写那个爱情的事在上面。爱情的那个 letter 怎么样？
情书。
情书啊，写给他，也许他留着。不过如果他那个爱人的爱的话才留，如果碰到那个。那个不喜欢他的人的话，连看也不看，就反作用。OK， 那多数男孩子都乱写，看到谁比较漂亮就乱写下去，不一定人家喜欢他，懂吗？像这个两个瞪来瞪去，这个也写了。不过我们不晓得谁瞪啊，你懂吗？好了好了，下一个。
报告师傅啊。今年我们和那个洛杉矶小中心跟哥斯达黎尼加小中心，我们合印了一个这个，一面是那个 SMTV， 另外一面是 calendar card，
嗯，
印了100多万份，是印到所有中美洲和南美洲各个地方去发，
嗯、okay.
哎，所以那个因为他们当地人不是很富裕，
懂懂，
所以他们都会。就是
拿那个 ，OK，
这 wallet 里头
，OK OK， 小小的那个 ，OK， 我懂 ，OK OK，、哎、那个还好，那个像名片一样嘛，
是是是，
还好一点了、哎，不过那个一年以后也不见了，不过一年以内还可以用得到，还好，不过那个 note 的情绪那些哦，不一定，还有卫生纸，我跟你讲过了啊 ，OK。既然已经印了就可以吧 ，OK， 以后不要再印就好了，我浪费钱放在那边干嘛 ？Yes， 下一个。
哎，包师傅，明年那个元宵节台湾灯会福尔摩沙灯会会在台南举行，那每年那个灯会哈、哦、在举行有将近600万人次。
Yeah， OK。
啊，这次那个台南县长跟那个副县长有找我们开会，邀请我们参加灯会。他说我们那个师傅的灯哈、哦嗯、很高雅，是一个名师设计的、
啊、
很漂亮。
展示
对，我们展示也可以花，顺便花、那个、
啊 ，OK OK。
哎，然后或是无上士电视的灯饰，跟师傅报告一下。
OK。
啊，谢谢师傅。
啊，不客气，谢谢。下一个，对我们利用嘛，任何方面都可以啊。不过能做什么就什么，对你们好了。OK。呀，也许还没有说救任何人，救自己嘛。OK。赚福报啊 ，OK， 啊、，Anyone else？ 下一个，
那有人在 Motorola 做事，然后他们看到师傅的那个 SMTV 的广告，
嗯，
那师傅的广告首先是拿着手机
，Yeah，Motorola，
那他就想要看，哎，是 Motorola，
Yeah， then， 然后讲完了。 看到师傅，然后摩托罗拉就这样子，要他 commission 给我了。呼，还有什么好笑的？真的好笑，哈哈。commission 没有拿到，哈，好什么笑？替他们买广告奖。Yeah, anyone else? Okay.
哎，师傅好，我们是温哥华小中心加拿大。我们第一次在登 AL 传单的时候呢，那个 agent 他说加拿大是一个很和平的国家，
嗯，
你们的传单有写到不杀生，那个有杀生的字就不行。我们说问题，我们这个不杀生就是不要让他杀生。我们就跟他谈师傅的道理，因为我们去的时候就把师傅的书啊什么资料都准备好了，
嗯，
那我们就先介绍师傅，他就慢慢就软化了，
嗯，
然后后来呢就慢慢他还是不答应让我们做，但是我们说你帮我们送看看，他说那我全部搞得要改掉，
嗯，
那我们不同意，那后来呢他这个就不让我们登，但是我们要登 SMTV 的时候，我们第一次打电话给他，他就想起来，他说我很想要跟你们做生意，我帮你们，所以 SMTV 他就让我们很顺就帮我们弄上去了，
嗯，
然后给我们拿的价钱本来很高，
嗯，
那后来呢我们也没有跟他讨价还价，
嗯，
他就自动说我们给你最好的价钱，
嗯，
然后最便宜的价钱放在最好的区给你们，
嗯，
然后还建议我们说哪个地方你可以放，这些有大学生很多，嗯，给我们很多很好的那个意见，
嗯，
那我们也是很开心说这个师傅，这个因为第一次接触，虽然我们是很挫折，可是我们没有放弃，
嗯，
就是因为那个小的，所以我们可以做到后面这个大的，
对对对
呀，谢谢，
嗯，啊，不客气。谢谢你们用功。要说这样子嘛，第一次不行，不过第二次就 OK 了。呀呀呀 ，Madam，
师傅，我是从加拿大伦敦来哈，就是因为就像刚才讲到传播素食的事情，因为我自己呢是在医学，就是家庭医生的诊所，然后我们就发现跟病人讲哈，作为医生来讲呢，病人就是比较能听得进去，
嗯，
因为现在呢好多病像高血压呀、糖尿病这些。
嗯嗯，
医生的角度都是先让他们改变饮食习惯，
嗯
嗯，所以呢我们都会跟他们发这个传单给他们， 嗯好多病人都会去看，
嗯，
而且呢有些病人回来就说，哎呀我都有吃素，
嗯，
好像觉得是有些改变，
嗯，
尤其是有一次新闻杂志登到说美国的糖尿病协会做了一个实验，就是99个病人，然后他一半是吃全素的，
嗯，
一半是吃传统的糖尿病，嗯，结果吃全素就非常好，这个就特别有说服力，
嗯
嗯，所以我就在想说，如果我们能够更多医生能够来提倡吃素的话，
嗯，
那病人接受起来就很容易。
我是说不是吃素为了身体健康而已，他们自己应该里面要感动才比较好，有爱心了，啊，然后吃素才比较好 ，OK？ 当然，大家吃素为了身体健康也是帮助一些了，不过那个没有转变什么太多那个气氛了，了解我意思吗？嗯，应该心里面转变有爱心了，那个时候从那边开始才比较好。
嗯嗯，就说一定他的心态很重要。
Yeah yeah yeah。
嗯，
不然的话，如果他没有爱护动物的话，那，今天你叫他吃素为了身体健康，明天他身体健康了以后，他就说：“哎呀，无所谓，我再去看看。”然后病之后再转回来，比方说这样子，懂不懂？他心如果不改的话，他换来换去啊，他吃了，不过没有爱护动物啊，
会
了解吗？哎呀 ，OK， 是很难说了，不过能做什么就做什么嘛 ，OK 呀、yeah.。
谢谢师傅。
哎，不客气。噗，动物啊，他们吃，他们也不是说很在意了，就是吃的太残了一点，啊，然后对人不好了。OK， 反正动物也跟我们一样啊，有一天也会死嘛，啊，嗯，有时候他们怕死，不过对他们也可以接受，就是对人不好了。OK， 呀、yeah.。如果他们心不改变，没有爱心的话，吃素吃肉无所谓啊，对他无所谓，对人没有什么帮助。OK， 嗯，也、yeah. 还有什么要问吗 ？No， 来要问哈。OK，
师父你好，我是中国来的，
嗯， 能够来的太好了，
心情现在非常激动
啊、哦！
我也想不到今天能看到你，我是
欢迎啊！
我是到
又来了又来了，我又开始哭闹出来了，讲过了 ，Yeah。
现在我们我
那个听好几次了，
大陆的同修非常感谢师父长期来对大陆同修的帮助和关心。
有吗？
现在还有个问题，我想，代表国内的同修问一下，现在他们都很想看到师父。
已经定过了。
我这次回去他们肯定要问你帮我问了没有，我们还有机会能看到师父吗？他们都有这个心情。
不知道讲了更难，等一下他们一直叫你们等，我就活不下去活不下去，知道吗？好了，什么时候看到就看到嘛，看到就知道了，看不到也不用问了啊。
谢谢
啊，不客气，我还没回答什么，不用谢。
师父被那个钗子啊，我们都印都在发。
哦，发下去了。发下去，我是发下去了。
这些我们都在做的，在工作都做。
哦，太好了。
还有收看无上书电视台啊，大家都很积极看。
可以看吗？看电脑哈。现在不能看，直接在电视看。
有时看到，有时看不到，干扰。
在大陆已经可以看到了。
可以看到。
哇。
可以看到。但是那时候效果不好，有时候断了
啊，
看不到。
好，没关系嘛，再看嘛，
断断续续。
哎，总比没有好了。
可以看，有时候还可以看。
哦，太好了，
晚上效果比较好，半夜比较好，白天都不太
好。白天不要看，半夜起来看。如果我是你们，我半夜起来看算了。
非常感谢师父。
师父，我有个笑话跟你讲。
笑话。OK， 讲讲看。
那有一次我跟我老板在坐车，然后他突然之间问我你有什么梦想。
嗯，
那我就那时候因为我一直以来我的梦想都是我希望师父能够开心就好了。那但是我又不敢这样讲，我就
怎么不敢。
那我就想说师父也是想世界和平，我就跟他说我的梦想就是世界和平。
嗯，
那个时候我真的那么想。然后回去的时候跟我师姐讲了，她说你以为你在选举世界小姐？我的梦想就是世界和平
啊。
但是我那时候真的只有那么想，我没有想到别的什么任何的其他的。
嗯，世界小姐。Any more? Anybody else? Otherwise, you go and have breakfast. Okay? 7 past already. Have breakfast, okay?
All right.
You want to hear some jokes?
Yes.
You understand English?
Yes.
How many understand English? Raise hand. I thought you are Korean. They told me you're Korean. Good. And the rest just standing around and squeezing about and, you know, sitting on top of the other guy. I have told them to make the second floor. Yeah? And then some of them can sit up there or crawl up there, you know? It's a temporary. Yeah, next year will be different, okay? New year, we have new things. No matter what, I make it out. I will try to work it out, okay? Right, okay. So now jokes or poem of Kabir? Joke or poem?
Kabir.
Why you like Kabir so much?
Cool.
Who's Kabir? Right hand. Who's jokes? So they're similar. What is, and the rest? Right hand again. Who's Kabir? Okay. And who's jokes? Okay. This guy joke. This joke. This is a poem. Okay. Joke. Poem. What? No. No. One. One. Okay. One. Two. Three.
Oh.
Was it fair or she cheat? He cheat?
No, it's fair.
Fair. Okay. Then we take the fair one. Oh my God! Don't even know to play this children game. Oh. We have okay. So we have Kabir and jokes. Huh? I make a joke first, since you're already laughing. Well, Kabir can be a little more seriously, okay? You've been sitting all day, let's take a good laugh, okay? There's a guy, you know, who has a son, who has a very long, long hair, yeah? And of course, father doesn't like son have long hair. Not many father who like son have long hair. Do you know any father who likes son have long hair? No, okay, okay. Oh, but this is a father. There is a father who doesn't like a son to have a long hair. He couldn't stand anymore after, you know, lecturing many long time and he never listened. So he dragged the son to the barber shop and ordered the barber to he give him a crew cut. What is a crew cut? Tell me. Very short, right? Very crew, right? Okay. And then after that, He told all his friends that he discovered that he has been raising somebody else's son. I don't know what happened. Tell me. Huh? He see his son's face for the first time or what? Probably looked like somebody else, huh? After the cut, huh? Okay. How come he don't recognize it before? Huh? Must be a blonde father, no? No, because the baby was born short hair, no? Yeah. Probably a baby you can't recognize much, right? When you grow older, you know. Okay, so you guys be careful if you have a long hair son, you never know who's who. Okay, now. And you know, the hairdresser, they're famous for talking, huh? I'm told like that. Is that true? They're talking while cutting your hair or doing your... Is that true? Mine was like that. Oh, man, everything. I don't need SMTV or radio, nothing. She tell me everything from A to Z. Before my hair is done, I know everything what's happening in the world. And I know about things that I didn't know about myself also. She keep telling me, oh, your ear is short, your ear is long, or whatever, you know. Okay. Now... And that guy, there's another father. He say that I have a 16-year-old son who was 6'3" until he got a haircut. Now he's only 5'7". You know, the punky hair. Okay. And we come back to the barber, you know. The guy walking to the barber shop, né? And he sat down in the car, in the chair, and he said to, and the barber put the towel around him. And then he told the barber immediately, before we start, let's make it clear, okay? I know already the weather's awful, okay? I don't care who wins the next big fight. I don't bet on the horse races. I know I am getting thin on top, but I don't mind. Now get on with it. And the barber say, well, sir, if you don't mind, I will be able to concentrate and cut your hair better if you don't talk so much. Surprise. I'm surprised. Okay. A man said to his friend, yesterday after I had a fight, my wife was on her knees. You know, with my wife, she was on her knees. My God, you are my idol. What did you do? And say nothing, as usual only. Oh, usual. So it happened often? No, not often. But yesterday she was on her knees for the first time. So, his friend was very amazed and impressed. But what did your wife said when she was on her knees? She said, get out from under the bed, you silly idiot. You got it?
Yeah.
You know very well, huh? I no need to explain. My God. When I first read it, I thought, why? You know? Because my husband didn't do it, so I didn't know. My ex-husband. Okay, now. I have never met a man who went under the bed like that before. So I need some other guy to explain to me and say, why? What's funny about this joke? And they understand everything, the man explained to me. A man entered a barber shop again and said to the barber, I'm tired of looking like everyone else. Yeah, I want a change. Part my hair from ear to ear for me. Are you sure, sir? Yes, the man said, definitely. So the barber did as he was told and satisfied the customer. And then he left the shop. 3 hours passed and the man re-entered the shop and said, put it back the way it was, he said. The barber said, what's wrong? So, are you tired of being a non-conformist already? No, the man say, I'm tired of people whispering in my nose. I don't see the ear, so the whisper. Okay. Two repairmen from a gas company were checking the house installations. And then after checking the last household, they made a bet on who would reach their vehicle first, with the loser have to buy a dozen drink that evening. Okay? They bet to run to the car, to their car. So they started to run as fast as they could, both of them. And while they were running and panting, they heard somebody behind them also running and panting. And they looked back and found that it was the lady of the last house, the owner of the last house, running after them. And then, so they stopped and asked the lady, what's wrong with her? She said, I saw you guys both running for lives, you know, after checking my gas installation, so I thought I should better run too. Dangerous. A homeless man said, oh, my kind lady, please give me a little money. I have not eaten for days. So the fat woman let out a very long sigh, like, oh, and said to the homeless, hungry man, I wish I have your discipline. I haven't eaten for days. A customer in a barber shop has been nicked 2 times by the razors from the barber. And he said to the barber finally, hey, barber, give me a glass of water. So the barber asked him, what's wrong, sir? Hair in your mouth? The customer said, no, I want to see if my neck leaks. Drink and then it comes out. So funny. So funny, yeah? I'm glad you found it funny. Yeah, yeah. After the whole day sitting, you need to exercise your lung, no? Okay. This is not a very good joke, but I guess you understand. The daughter asked her father, Dad, do you have something more scary for me to read? More horrifying, you know, like a horror story. You have something more scary, horror story for me to read? Yes, of course, her father replied. There is one that scares me even after 25 years. So surely not. Are there such thing that could scare someone after 25 years? Daddy says, sure, I can show you. And what is that? It's our marriage certificate. The girl who blinked at the other guy yesterday could have listened to this, the Chinese girl. I'm just kidding. It cannot be that bad. You're all still alive, no? With children and all, so it can't be that bad, is it? This is for some guy who has been having really bad experience, you know? John was riding a bicycle, and because he was not careful, he hit a pedestrian. He helped the victim stand up and said to him, hey man, you are really lucky today. The pedestrian was absolutely furious and said, you are truly horrible to say such a thing, that I'm lucky after hitting me with your bicycle. See how my leg is bruised here? Oh, the Johnny says, surely you're lucky. Today is my day off. Otherwise, I would have been driving a heavy truck. Positive, no? Okay, what now? What next? The computer matchmaker. Shirley, the girl, she's only 165 centimeter high, yeah? So she sought help from a matchmaking agency that used computers to look for possible partners, yeah? Compatible partners. So said the manager to her, you please list out your requirements, yeah? And so the girl lists out like this, must not be too tall, loves wearing a tuxedo, and loves playing winter sport. That's a requirement for her future partner. The manager entered her requirements into the computer, and after a while, the answer appeared on the screen. Mr. Penguin. Computer, no? Computer knows everything. It's fit perfect, no? Not be too tall and wear a tuxedo all the time and play in winter sport. Cute, huh? Yeah. The teacher asked the student, can you tell me where was Solomon's temple? You know Solomon, the personage in the Bible? Yeah. The student say, sir, it's on the side of his forehead. On the side of his head. Temple. Temple. A female tailor, you know, the one who sew clothes, make clothes, was working by the riverside. And she dropped her thimble into the river. So she cried loudly in grief. Hearing her crying, God appeared and asked, my child, why are you crying? So the woman told God that she has lost her thimble, yeah? And that it is very essential, too, for her to earn a living, yeah? What can a tailor do without a thimble, no? A thimble, right? Yeah. You know what a thimble is? What is it? Yeah, you cap on your finger so you can push a needle and it doesn't hurt your finger then. Okay. When the cloth is too thick, your needle cannot go through well, so you use a thimble to cap your finger and to push the needle instead of your flesh. Okay, good. So God dipped his hand into the water and grabbed a thimble made of gold and inlaid with pearls and asked her, is this your thimble? No, replied the woman. God again dipped his hand into the river and picked up a silver thimble inlaid with jade. Is that yours? No, sir. Impressed by the honesty of the woman, God gave her all three. Yeah. You know, he make another, take another one of hers and then give all three of them. Yeah. Several years after, the woman was taking a stroll by the riverside with her husband. When her husband slipped and fell into the river and sank very fast, the woman cried out loud for help again, and God again appeared. My child, why are you crying this time? Oh God, my husband has fallen into the river. So very quickly, God picked up a man from the water who happened to be the movie star Brad Pitt. So God asked her, is this your husband? Still crying, the woman answered, yes. Oh, God said, you are lying. He's not your husband. God was, you know, annoyed. So the woman quickly defended herself, saying, dear God, please forgive me. I am forced to lie. If I said Brad Pitt was not my husband, you would pick another movie star from the river. Yeah, maybe Tom Cruise or something. Yes. And then only if I deny him again, you would pick up my husband. And when I finally say yes, then you would give all three men to me. Like last time you did with the thimble. As you can see, I'm not very strong. I'm tired already to have only one husband. One is enough. I told you, didn't I, huh? One partner is enough. Even a woman knows it. The girl asked a date, you know. Did you kiss me when the light went out? The boy said, no, I didn't. So the girl said, it must be that fellow over there, you know, on my left. Yeah. The boy said, starting to get up, I'm going to teach him a lesson or two. And the girl said, you should learn a lesson or two from him. Two friends met on the street, and A asked B, well, how is it about the relationship between you and the banker's daughter? Oh, pretty cool, pretty cool. I'm getting some encouragement. Ah, really? Is she beginning to smile sweetly at you or something? No, not really, but last night she told me that this is the last time she would say no. he think she will say yes the next time. A boy was taking a girl, you know, in his car on a lonely country road on a moonlight, in a moonlit night, and suddenly the engine coughed and the car stopped. The young man said, oh, that's funny. I wonder what's that knocking was. So the girl said, well, I can not tell you for sure, but I know one thing. There's not opportunity. Opportunity not. The boy asked the girl, why won't you marry me? Is there someone else better? You know, so the girl said, there must be. That's better. You know the answer before, right? The boy asked the another boy, what is so strange or and unusual about your girlfriend? And the other boy said, well, she chews on her nails. And the friend said, wow, lots of girls chew on her nails, nothing strange or unusual. He said, you mean toenails? And a friend asked another friend, I don't know why my girlfriends always close her eyes when I kiss her. And the other friend said, look in the mirror and you know. Georgia declared his love to his sweetheart, say, oh, Eliza, you must marry me. I love you so much. There can be no other except you. Yeah. So Eliza said, but I don't love you. I don't love you. You must find happiness with a beautiful woman. And he said, I don't want a beautiful woman. I want you. Ugly. Just a slip of the tongue. He didn't mean it. A woman, huh, had her portrait taken at the instant photo booth, na? And then went to get the automatic finish photos. And looking at the photos, she was so shocked. She said, I look like an ape in the photos. A woman behind her said, coolly, those are my photos. Yours are still being processed. Oops. The boy said to his girlfriend, you know, sweetheart, since I met you, I can't eat, I can't sleep, I can't drink. The girl said, why not? The boy said, I'm broke. Spent too much money on dates. A boy said to another boy, my girlfriend takes advantage of me. What do you mean by that? The other boy asked. Well, I invited her out to dinner, and she asked me if she could bring a date. just to pay. You know? An old man was hit by a taxi, and he quarreled with the taxi driver. The taxi driver said, it was not my fault. My driving technique is superb, and I have 10 years of experience. So the old man said, is that so? I have been walking for 15 years. And this is the first time I've been hit. Who has more experience, right? After a blind date, a fellow mentioned to his friend, after I got home last night, I felt a lump in my throat. You really like her, eh? The friend asked. And the boy replied, no, no, she's a karate expert. Oh, man. Look before you leap, huh? Do you have a book that say man, master of woman? A young man asked the librarian, yeah, the bookkeepers, no? The shop librarian, huh? Librarian, okay. Okay, that shall be fiction counter on your left. Doesn't exist. It's only in fiction, right? The boy said, oh, look at the cow and the calf rubbing noses in the pasture. That sight makes me want to do the same. So the girlfriend said, well, go ahead. The cow won't mind. The boy, with one hand cupped over the other, say, if you can guess what I have in my hand, I will take you out tonight. The girl say, an elephant. She doesn't want him. An elephant in my hand? I must be kidding. Okay. So the boy said, no, but that's close enough. I pick you up at 7. The girl asked the boy, do you think you could be happy with a girl like me? The boy replied, perhaps, if she isn't too much like you. after checking into his hotel room, a man, a businessman, saw a dead cockroach on the floor. So he called the service counter and demanded to speak to the manager. When he got through to the manager, he complained with great commotion. "Please calm down, sir," said the manager. "Since the cockroach is already dead, it won't do you any harm." The businessman said, "The deceased is fine, but the relatives and friends who come to attend his funeral really make me sick." There's a man who has a lot of gray hair. I'm walking on the street when a stranger went up to him and asked, "Are you young with gray hair?" The man replied, "No, I just have a young face." Is that funny? A movie star asked, "Do you believe that I sleep only 1 hour each day?" The reporter replied, "Then what do you do the rest of the day?" The movie star says, "Dozing away." Sleeping anyway. The boy asked his friend, "How come you go steady with Elena?" And the friend said, "Well, she's different from other girls." "How different?" "Oh, she's the only girl who will go out with me." Patient to doctor. "Doc, I snore as soon as I fall asleep." Doctor say, "Then do you snore very loud? Snore very loud?" Patient say, "Yes, very, very loud." The doctor say, "Is your wife fed up with you?" The patient say, "I'm not married yet." The doctor say, "Since you sleep alone, it's not a problem, is it?" The patient say, "What do you mean not a problem?" "I have lost 5 jobs snoring on the work." At work. What is the definition of a successful man? Anybody know?
Man who has success.
Yeah, true, but that he earns more than his wife could spend. Well, in some cases, I don't say you, but... And what is the definition of a successful woman? No, the one who found such a man. In that case, I think I'm a loser. I think I'm a loser. The couple trying to split up, you know. The husband asks, "Well, how could I leave you?" "Yeah? My dear, how? How can I leave you?" So the husband said, "By train, by plane, or taxi, just out." "Oh, however, I don't care." "Alice, do you love me?" The boy asked. The girl said, "Yeah." The boy said, "Would you be willing to live on my income?" I mean, maybe a little, I guess. So the girl said, "Yes, if you will get another for yourself." Everything. All mine. The girl said to the boy, "I'm telling you for the last time, you cannot kiss me." The boy said, "Ah, I know you'll be weakened." I mean, it's the last time she say no, you know. She won't say no again, that's what he mean. The girl asked the boy, "Do you love me?" The boy say, "Yes, of course, my dear." And the girl asked again, "Would you die for me?" The boy say, "No, mine is an undying love." How cool. Johnny asked his girlfriend, "Don't you think I'm rather good looking?" So, June said, in a way. So Johnny asked, what kind of way? June said, as far away as possible. There's a minister, huh? Came to his one of his flock's house and knock at the door. Yeah? The churchgoers, yeah? Knock at the door. And there's a voice inside from the husband asking out, is that you, Angel? And the minister said, no, no, but I'm from the same department. In the classroom, the teacher just entered and immediately asked the class, if any one of you think that you are the ugliest in the class, please stand up. After a while, the class stood up, and the teacher asked, you really think that you are the ugliest one in the class? The kid said, no, I just couldn't bear to see you standing there alone. In a church, you know, the pastor just went on and on and on with the sermon, yeah? And it was very, very hot in there. Mm. At last, the pastor stopped and asked the congregation, what more, my friends, can I say? So in the back of the church, a voice answered, earnestly, amen. When the priest say amen, that means end of the sermon. As a little granddaughter, yeah, I went to visit grandmother with the whole family, yeah. And everybody concentrate in stay in the living room, and the mom say that today we're going to pray for, especially for grandma. And then the daughter, what do we pray for? Say, we pray that God will make her live long, long and very old, to be very, very old age. So the daughter said, no, I'd rather pray that God make her younger. The teacher announced the result to the class after midterm exam, before he giving back the mark test papers to them. So the teacher said, the test result for this mathematics test was really remarkable. The number of people who got 90 points is the same as those who got 80 and above. Wow. Coincidentally, the number of people who got 70 and above is the same as those who got 60 and above. Are you laughing? Huh? And then, wow, the whole class cheered with joy. Then a boy asked the teacher, how many of us failed? The teacher took a deep breath and replied slowly, the number of people who failed the test is the same as the number of the whole class. The minister, finishing up the service one morning and say, next Sunday, I'm going to preach on the subject of liars. And in this connection, as a preparation for my discourse, I should like you all to read the 17th chapter of Mark. So on the following Sunday, the preacher rose to begin and said, now then, all of you have done as I requested and read the Mark 17. Please, whoever did it, raise your hand. The whole congregation raise their hand. And then the preacher said to them, you are the people I want to talk to, because there's no 17th chapter of Mark. A spider was very much in love with an ant and was rejected, because when he expressed his love, the ant didn't want to take. So the spider shouted, why? Why don't you love me? So the aunt very shyly said, "My mom said that those hanging on the web, I mean internet, those who hang on the web all day are bad guys." Hanging on the web all day. A youngster demanded his grandfather, "Why do you keep reading your Bible all day long?" So the grand say, "Well, you might say I am cramming for my final examination." Oh, grandma, exam. You got it? Three sons of a lawyer, a doctor, and a minister were talking about how much money their fathers made. So the lawyer's son said, "My father goes into a court on a case and often comes home with as much as $1,500. So the doctor's son said, "My father performs an operation and earns as much as $2,000. So the minister's son, determined not to be outdone, said, "That's nothing. My father preaches for just 20 minutes on Sunday morning, and it takes four men to carry the money." A father hoped to develop his son's character, so he gave him a penny and a quarter as he was leaving for Sunday school. "Now, John, you put whichever one you want in the offering plate of the church now, a Sunday school church." So when the boy returned, his father asked which corn he has given. So Johnny answered, "Well, just before they sent around the plate, the preacher said, 'The Lord loves a cheerful giver.' So, and I knew that I could give a penny a lot more cheerful than I would give the quarter." So I give the Lord a penny. Cheerful. A couple was touring the Capitol in Washington, D.C., and the guy pointed out a tall, benevolent gentleman as the congressional chaplain. The lady asked, "What does the chaplain do? Does he pray for the Senate or the House?" The guy answered, no, sir. "He gets up, looks at the Congress, then he pray for the country." Pray for the nation. A hat was passed around the church congregation for an offering for the visiting minister. And then afterward, it's returned to him. Conspicuously and embarrassingly empty. Oh. Slowly and deliberately, the person inverted the hat and shook it meaningfully and vigorously. And then he raised his eyes in heaven and said, "Thank you, my Lord, that I still have my hat back." That they didn't take it. A minister asked the little girl what she thought of her first church service at his church. Nah? So the girl said, "The music was nice, but the commercial was too long." After a long and dry sermon, the minister announced that he wished to meet with the church board. The church board, na? Board, na? B-O-A-R-D, yeah. Following the close of the sermon. So the first man to arrive was a stranger. So the man, the priest said to him, "You misunderstood my announcement. This is a meeting of the board." "Only," said the minister, na? And the stranger said to the minister, I know. "But if there is anyone here more bored than I am, I would like to meet him." Definitely a board member. Okay, guys. Okay, a couple more, and then we close. Oh, so make the best laughter before you leave, huh? 5 years old, Johnny complained to his mother. Mom, little puppy bit and tore my shoes. So mom said, you ought to teach him a good lesson. Okay, so Johnny said, Mom, I already did. I drank all the milk in his bowl. I'm sure he won't do it again. Father to the child, my child, I punish you because I love you. And the son said, I know, Dad, but I do not deserve so much love. Could have a little less love, huh? An ant and an elephant became sworn brothers. Fancy that. The elephant was injured in a traffic accident one day and was rushed to the hospital. Hearing such a bad news, the ant hurried to the hospital and met a rabbit on the way, who asked him why he was in such a rush. The ant said, my big brother was badly hurt. I am rushing to the hospital to give him a blood transfusion. Very big heart indeed. There was a very energetic young priest who had a thriving country church. He was always prodding his people to do greater things for God. Yeah, and he spent much of his time preparing his sermon. And then there was a deacon in his congregation who did very little and seemed to care less. Yeah, it caused the young priest to feel very concerned. So on several occasions, the preacher would tell him exactly what he thought in his mind. So the old deacon never caught the point at all. So the old deacon always thought he was referring to somebody else, just like you guys. There's no need hinting to you. I just go direct, it's better. And you might not even understand. So one Sunday, the priest made it a point as to whom he was talking. You know, make it clear. So following the service, the deacon said to the priest, oh, preacher, you sure told them today again. The next sermon was still more pointed than ever. But again, the deacon didn't understand a thing. So he come and praised the priest again. Oh, preacher, you sure told them today again, didn't you? So the next Sunday, it rained so much that no one came to the church except this one deacon. So the preacher thought, oh, this is a good opportunity that he would tell him whom he meant, you know, about the way he should change his life. So the sermon went straight to the deacon, who was the only one in the congregation anyway. So following the service, the deacon walked up to the preacher and said again, preacher, you sure told them if they had been here. My God, what for you have ears, huh? After delivering some goods to a lunatic asylum, the driver found that his truck had a flat tire. Yeah, somebody flapped his tire. So he took it off to change a new one. Just as he was trying to fit the spare tire, his hand slipped and he dropped all the lug nuts into a ditch. He couldn't retrieve the lug nuts, you know, the one that screwed the tire together, and was at a loss at what to do. So a patient passed by and asked him what was wrong. So no one else there, so he explained to the lunatic what happened. Yeah. saw the lunatic say to him, "You can't even solve such a simple problem. No wonder you are only a truck driver. All you need to do is take one lug nut from each of the remaining three tires and use them to fix the fourth tire. After that, you can drive to the nearest garage station to refit the missing lug nuts." Wow, how good. So the truck driver was really impressed and amazed. So he asked the lunatic, "Since you are so smart, why are you here in the lunatic asylum?" So the lunatic replied, "I'm here because I'm crazy, not because I'm stupid." A Sunday school teacher asked her students to draw a picture of Jesus' family. After the pictures were brought to her, she saw that some of the youngster has drawn the conventional pictures of the family and the manga, the family riding on the donkey and so on. Okay. But she called up one little boy to ask him to explain his drawing. Because in his drawing, he showed an airplane with four heads sticking out of the windows. Jesus' family. So she asked him, "I can understand that you drew three of the heads to show Joseph, Mary, and Jesus, but who's the fourth head?" The youngster answered, Oh, that's the Pontius, the pilot." The same name. It's cute. Pontius the pilot. Johnny has a very talkative wife. One day he said to his friend, "You know what? I went with my wife to the seaside for vacation. And guess what happened?" The friend said, "What happened?" So Johnny said, "Her tongue was tanned by the sun." Talk too much. Terrible husband. Nothing else than but the tongue. Congregation member said to the priest, "Pastor, how did you get that cut on your face?" So the pastor said, "I was thinking about my sermon this morning, and I wasn't concentrating on what I was doing, so I cut myself when I was shaving." So the member of congregation said, "That's too bad. That's too bad. Next time you'd better concentrate on your shaving and cut your sermon." Well, I don't have any beer, so I will never have that problem. You never have a chance. The manager said something to the potential employee. "I have many types of machines in our factory. Are you familiar with machines?" The potential employee replied, "I am familiar with four types of machine, in fact." "Good, good. Which is the four types of machine that you're familiar with?" Namely, the employees, namely computer game machines, beverage vending machines, ATM machines, and elevators. Little Johnny got a tiny drum for a birthday. So several days later, when his dad came home after work, his mom told him, "Oh, I think our neighbor downstairs doesn't like the noise from Johnny's drum, but he was very implicit. Oh, so the husband asked, "So what did he say?" "Well," replied the wife, "this afternoon he gave Johnny a small knife and asked him what was inside the drum that's produced such a beautiful sound." Finished. Oh, what a very intelligent tactic, huh? A parishioner, a priest, had doze off during the morning service. Oh, parishioner, I mean the churchgoer, I guess, yeah? Okay. Dozing off while during the morning service. So the pastor asked, will all people who want to go to heaven please stand up? So everybody stood up except the sleeping churchgoer. After they all sat down again, the pastor continued, well, will all who want to go to the other place stand up? Someone suddenly dropped a songbook, and the sleeping man jumped to his feet and stood sheepishly facing the preacher. He mumbled confusedly, well, well, preacher, I don't know what we are voting for, but it looks like you and I are the only ones for it. A little boy in a Sunday school forgot his lines for a presentation. His mother, sitting in the front row to prompt him, gesture and form the words silently with her lips to help him out. But it didn't help him, her. Her son's memory was completely blank. So finally she leaned forward and whispered the cue into his ear. I am the light of the world. Yes. So the kid beamed, you know, in his eyes and with great feeling and confidence speak very loudly. My mother is the light of the world. Right in the middle of the service, just before the sermon, one of the congregation members just remembered that she forgot to turn off the gas under the roast, yeah? So hurriedly, she scribbled a note and passed it to the usher to give it to her husband. But the usher misunderstood, unfortunately, and took it to the pulpit and gave it to the priest. And the priest unfolded the note and read aloud, please go home and shut off the gas. He was talking. Please go home and shut off the gas. Oops. In the office of a foreign company, there was a following poster. It says, theory means we know the reason why, but nothing can be done. And practicality means we don't know why, but things are being done. In our company, we have merged theory with practicality. Nothing is being done and no one knows why. How practical. A Sunday school teacher asked the little girl, did you say your prayer every night? Do you say your prayer every night? The girl said, no, no, not every night. Because some nights I don't want anything from God. Only when she wants some. After putting out a huge fire, the firemen are beginning to clear and pack their equipment. Among the onlookers, a mother said to her son, did you see that? Did you see that? After the game is over, they always pack and clear the toys for home. A Sunday school teacher asked her class to draw a picture illustrating a Bible story. So one paper handed to the teacher with a picture of a big car. An old man with a long whiskers flying in the breeze who was driving the car in that picture. A man and a woman were seated in the back seat, puzzled. So very puzzled. The teacher asked little John to explain what the meaning of his drawing. So Johnny said, "Why, that is God. He's driving Adam and Eve out of the Garden of Eden." Okay, guys. Let's go have dinding, okay? See you later. Okay? So now you're going to have dinner, I'm going to have breakfast. How about that? I'm a little hungry too, no? Are we not? Are you not? You are, right? You haven't eaten since morning. Okay, buon appetito. Ciao, ciao. See you. Nice to love, eh?
Yeah.
See you later, love. See you. Thank you.